long ago.
It's an iconic tune from not so long ago. Forty years on and Herbs are back. Only this time the pioneers of Pacific reggae are on the big screen.
Definitely for anyone who wants to see what was happening back in the 70s and 80s and to see that these historical events that were happening were captured on song and why today Herbs is still relevant.
The new film, Herbs, Songs of Freedom, is a trip down memory lane for some of the band's key members and showcases how their songs became social commentary.
We just released What's Be Happen.
Formed in the late 1970s, Herbs wrote about issues like the Bastion Point occupation and the Dawn Raids.
What was happening in New Zealand was the Dawn Raids, where the police could come to your place at almost any time to check if you've got a passport and deport you if you didn't. So I saw the similarities between what was happening in America and Australia, and saw that our story needed to be told and to be brought together as songs, because songs are, to me, are the most powerful way of expressing.
Their first album, Long Ago, didn't get much airplay because it was seen as controversial. But it was the 1982 hit French Letter, a protest song against the nuclear testing at Mururoa, that went off. It spent 11 weeks on the charts.
Greenpeace, they told me they were using that song to encourage them as they like would start to block boats and stuff. They played French Letter. I loved that. So I knew that the power of music and people taking actions, you know, with the message like embedded in them, I knew that was the way to go.
The unique sound of Herbs also hooked in some of the big names in Kiwi music. The film documents how the lineup of Māori, Pasifika and Pākehā musicians changed over the years but remained true to their roots.
When you tell your story, make sure your story's right.
We were voicing what people were thinking at the time, and we did it in a way that was articulate, especially when I studied songwriting. And then the way that when we got together, we weren't just a reggae band. When we got together, you know, each musician like Spence and Dilworth and Phil and Fred, they were all really good at doing covers. So it wasn't like starting as a reggae band. It was really getting great musicians together, great songs together. And I believe that's why the songs have stayed the course of time.
I knew that we had something, because this was the first time that Maori Polynesian people were saying something.
Three of the original members passed away last year, but the music lives on.
Each one of us do have children that are very musical, more like the Sons of Herbs type of thing. And if we wanted to, we could easily work together with them and continue the legacy another generation on.